Hi everyone, and welcome to the second tutorial video of the Matchbox Restoration channel. I have taken a break for some while now, but I felt like doing some more videos for you all. How better to start than with some tutorial videos to help some of you out with your own restoration projects. Some people have asked about how to put on new axles without the need for a tool or a drill press. That's why I'll be showing you how to use the axle replacement kit you can find online. I'll put a link in the description below. Let's see what comes with the kit. First of all, there's a couple of 16-inch tubes that come in a handy plastic tube so they won't get bent when putting them away with the rest of your restoration tools. In the small plastic bag, you'll find the wheel caps if you like, that fit nicely into the tubes. To get started, we need to measure the necessary width of the axle by putting the tube onto the base of the model. The best way to figure out the width is to put the tube on with the wheels already mounted. Fit the tube until it just doesn't protrude the wheel itself and cut the tube to length. Stop right there. Don't try to cut the tubes with pliers. The tube will bend and you won't be able to fit the wheel caps on. You do want to cut the tube with a Dremel tool or even with a small hacksaw. This way the tube is cut, not bent. So I redo the measuring and make a small mark where to cut the tube. Then I take my Dremel tool to cut it right to length. Don't forget to use the safety goggles. You may want to file off the rough edges after cutting. I'm using a cheap file set you can find in most hardware stores. I'll put one in the description below. When cut to length, you can check one last time if everything fits before gluing the wheel caps in place. Then cut the wheel caps to length. You won't need more than 7 or 8 mm to secure them into the tubes. You can cut them shorter, but it might get a bit fiddly to insert them that way. I'm using epoxy glue. Keep away from using CA glue, as this will most likely leave some white marks on the tires after drying. If you don't like to use epoxy glue, you can always choose to use another type of glue, or even no glue at all, if you just put your models on display. Use some tweezers to grab the wheel caps and dip them into the epoxy glue before inserting them into the tubes. The side where you cut the tube might be a tighter fit because of the cutting, but normally they will fit okay. And that's it, new axles and wheel caps. Let me know if you found this tutorial useful and if you like other methods I use explained in a bit more detail. Please click the subscribe button to get notified when I'm uploading a new video. Also keep your eye out on the community tab of my channel where I'll let you know what I'm working on. And as always, thank you for watching.